Today we're going to be calibrating a tank sprayer which contains booms and nozzles on a tractor. One of the most important things you can do with a brand new sprayer is determine how many gallons per acre of water that you're applying on a field. The reason being is that most chemicals, whether it be a herbicide, insecticide, pre-emergent, there's a lot of different chemicals that you use. They're going to relate the volume and the mixing rate at gallons per acre and then therefore ounces per acre of the product. So if you don't know how many gallons of water per acre your tractor is spraying, it's going to be impossible for you to determine how many ounces of the chemical that you need to mix with your water, and that could be disastrous both in results and in cost. So the very first thing you want to do on your tank sprayer is look at the nozzle spacing, and we're going to measure the distance between the nozzles. This particular tractor has a 20-inch spacing of nozzles, and we are going to refer to a chart developed by Ohio State University that makes this very simple. The concept is that there is 128 ounces of liquid in a gallon of water. So knowing that, we're going to see how much distance is required for one nozzle to spray one 128th of an acre's worth of water. With that being said, don't get too mired down in those details. The important thing is to remember to check the spacing between your nozzles, and then we're going to consult the chart that's provided by the Ohio State University website. Looking at the chart, we see that a 20-inch spacing of nozzles requires the tractor to travel 204 feet of distance in our setup and check. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a flag in the ground, take a measuring wheel, and run off 204 feet and mark another flag. Then we are going to drive the tractor that distance at the same speed that we would be spraying. Most tractors, most ATVs included, a good speed for spraying to make sure that you're not traveling too slow or too fast is right around 4 miles an hour minimum, up to about 5 miles per hour. And on the typical tractor, when you're running a three-point sprayer that's driven by the drive shaft, you want to run that at the 540 setting, which means 540 revolutions on the drive shaft, which typically equates to about 2200 RPMs in the tractor. Okay, now we're driving the tractor in our test run at 4 miles per hour from start to finish, and we're using a stopwatch to determine how many seconds it takes to travel that distance. In this particular example, it took 37 seconds for this John Deere tractor to travel that 204 feet. So now that we've determined it, the 37 seconds to travel that distance, what are we going to do next? We take a graduated measuring cup, and now we're going to turn the tractor sprayer on at the same PTO speed that we've been running, which is 2200 RPM. Now that we've allowed the sprayer to run for 37 seconds, we can look on our graduated measuring cup and we see that we have 18 ounces of water captured. This gets back to that awesome chart developed by Ohio State. We can completely take that and relate that to gallons per acre. 18 ounces in this test shows us that our tractor is applying 18 gallons of water per acre. What if we're putting what we feel is too little or too much? And by the way, how much is too little or too much? A good average gallon per acre usage on a tractor or an even ATV sprayer is somewhere between 12 and 18 gallons per acre. So in this particular case, we were pretty well right on the range of the upper end of the range. If we have something that's either too low or too high, what do we do? How do we bring it back into sync? There's three methods that we can do. The first and easiest is just to change the pressure on your regulator. Make sure you're testing that at RPM, at running speed, in this example, 2200 RPM. Say we were set at 35 PSI on the regulator, it's really simple just to turn a knob and bring it down to 25 or 20 and do the test again and see where we land on our output of water. The second way we can do that is simply just increase or decrease tractor travel speed. In this example, we were traveling at 4 miles per hour. If we felt that the rate was too high, we could travel at 5 miles an hour and do the test again. The third way, and this is the most tricky or the most cumbersome, is to change the nozzles on your tractor to either put out more or less volume of water. Most tractor sprayers are set up to produce and provide that average amount of spray, so it would be highly unlikely that you'll have to do that third step. The other two are much easier.